Welcome friends to our third C tutorial. Hope you would have gone through our last tutorial. In this part of the tutorial, we would be talking about the tokens. So before we start, I want to state that anything in this world has individual or the smallest unit. Like cell are the smallest unit of life in our body. Similarly, tokens are the smallest individual units that make up a complete C program. Just imagine of a brick. Many a brick come together to form a house. Similarly, tokens come together to form a program. Now, tokens can be categorized into 6 categories. These are keywords, identifier, constant, strings, operators, and punctuators. What are keywords? So let us talk about the keywords. Basically, keywords are the reserved words or predefined words whose meaning is already known to the compiler. Each keyword performs a particular task, and we cannot use keyword to name something or as the identifiers. Each keyword performs a particular task. They have different properties. 32 keywords had been defined by C89. Few of the examples are int, float, void, goto, etc. We would be coming across many keywords as we proceed with programming and further tutorials. Now, let's talk about identifiers. Identifiers are the name given to variable, constant, functions and user-defined data. We would be talking about functions in later tutorials. Suppose, if we all did not had a name, then how we would be communicating with each other, how we would be calling each other eventually. There would be a big blunder. Similarly, identifiers are just like names. They help name different parts in a program. Like, A is the identifier in int A, or B is the identifier in float B. We would understand more easily about identifier as we proceed with programming in later tutorials. Now, let's talk about constants. Constants are those quantities whose value are fixed and cannot be changed or altered. If we go in detail, then constants have a fixed value in the memory. For example, 1, 2 are the constants. We cannot change their values. And if we add the keyword const for int a or in front of anything, then it is also a constant whose value cannot be altered. Here int a is equal to 5. Now, in any proceeding programming, we cannot change the value of a. Now, let's talk about strings. Strings in a C programming language is actually one-dimensional array of characters which is terminated by a null character. Now you would be worrying about the arrays. Array is a particular chapter in C of which we would be dealing in later tutorials. Just you need to understand that each letter in the word hello is a character, like H is a character, E is a character, L is a character, and the group of the characters form a string, or like a group of letters form a word. Now let's talk about the operators. What basically an operator is? An operator is a symbol that tells the compiler to perform specific mathematical or logical operation. Like the plus sign would instruct the compiler to add, whereas the minus sign would instruct the compiler to subtract. There are various categories of operators which we would be discussing in later tutorials. Currently, you just need to know that operators are special symbols that would instruct to the compiler to perform specific mathematical or logical operations. Now, let's talk about the punctuators. Punctuators separate two statements. In fact, the whole C program is made up of punctuators. This semicolon indicates the end of the statement, and the curly braces indicate a block of code. while the square brackets indicate an array. While programming, in our later tutorials, we would come across many of these punctuators. If you liked our video, then like and do subscribe and share. Please pass your comments in form of feedback and help us grow. Thank you.